How to control the mind from negative thinking. Your mind is in the state it is in because that is the information that you feed to your mind. If you're constantly observing something, then that information is being fed to your brain through your eyes. If you're constantly listening to something, that information is being fed to your brain through your ears, and so on and so forth. And so your mind, if it's in a negative state, it is because that is the information that you are feeding your brain, either through the conversations around you or through the things that you're watching on the TV or the people you socialize with or the environment that you're in, and so on and so forth. Because all these things is information coming into your brain. And so your mind is the way it is because that's what you're constantly focused on. That's what you keep thinking. That's what you're dwelling on. That's what you're meditating on. And so on and so forth. So the solution is not to fight those thoughts, because when you try to fight those thoughts and try to push them out, when you try to fight them in this manner, nothing happens. The only thing that happens is that you become drained. It's like saying, don't focus on pink, don't focus on pink, don't focus on pink. What are you going to focus on? Pink. And so it's not about fighting these thoughts, because that just makes them more prominent, more powerful within you, and then you think of them more and more. It's not about fighting the thoughts, because that just drains you, it leaves you drained, and nothing ever changes. In fact, it makes matters worse. The solution is to start feeding your mind with new information. So stop feeding the information into your mind of that negativity, and you're going to stop thinking of those things. Start feeding new information into your mind. So for example, let's say you're dealing with a problem with your spouse. Stop feeding that information into your brain. And he said, and she said, and he did, and she did, and this is happening. And then you start creating worst case scenarios in your mind as well, you know, making up stories of your own as well. And so as you're feeding that information into your mind, you're meditating on that information, and then it becomes more prominent, more powerful within you. And then your mind just keeps going on and on and playing that same story over and over again, like a broken record. So start feeding your mind with new information. So for example, stop focusing on the problem, because focusing on the problem never solves a problem. You never solve a problem from the same level of consciousness that created that problem. You have to rise above the problem in order for you to be able to solve that problem. So stop focusing on the problem, stop focusing on the storm, and start focusing on Jesus, and start focusing and meditating on the very word of God that speaks about the problem you are faced with. So for example, let's say you're faced with health issues, and the doctor said to you, you've got a couple of years to live, or a couple of months to live, or you're diagnosed with this disease and it's not curable, and so on. Nothing is incurable for Jesus. Let's just start there. And it's incurable when you've got a few months to live, and so on and so forth. Stop focusing on that. Stop replaying that in your mind, because the more you replay that in your mind, the more you replay that in your mind, it's like saying pink, 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 pink. The only thing you're going to think about is pink. You see? So so let's say, for example, you've got some bad news about your health. Stop playing that in your mind. Stop thinking about that and dwelling on that and meditating on that. And then you go about and you start talking about that on the phone with your friend. Yeah, and the doctor said this about my. Stop speaking this destruction over your life. Stop thinking about it. And instead, start feeding your brain with new information, not just any random information. Find the word of God that speaks about the specific issue you're dealing with. So in the case of health, God says, by his stripes we are healed. God says, I will heal you. God says. There's so many Bible verses regarding health. So you start feeding your brain with that. You start speaking to your friends over the phone about that. And then when you start doing so, you're feeding your brain with new information, and then that's the information that's going to play in your mind, and not the negative information. And it's the same story whether you receive negative news. Stop playing that in your mind. Find the Bible verse that speaks about that exact issue you're dealing with, and then focus on that. Maybe you're being evicted from your flat. Stop focusing on that. Stop speaking about that. Stop focusing on the storm. Stop focusing on how big that mountain is, because then that just grows in your mind, and then you can't stop that mind chatter, and it just drives you crazy. I know, because I've been there. Then it makes you depressed, and then it makes you anxious, it makes you worry, it makes you fearful. And all these things, they're not of God. God nowhere in the Bible says, you know what, fear or worry or get anxious. In fact, over and over and over again in the Bible, God tells us, don't fear, don't worry, be anxious about nothing, and so on and so forth. that because you're too busy focused on worry and anxiety and fear, these are the things that are growing in your mind. You're meditating on them. These are the things that are growing in your mind. So your mind becomes, because your mind is feeding off of that negativity, your mind becomes negative. But if you start feeding on the word of God, it says, be anxious for nothing. Don't worry. Don't fear. God says, I'm going to be with you. God says, I will lift you up. God says, I will be with you to the very end. God says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. God says, I will provide for you. I will heal you. I will make you prosper. I have plans for you to prosper, and so on and so forth. And start thinking about that. Feed your soul, your very spirit, with the very spiritual food of God. And then that will be playing in your mind. And automatically, these old thoughts with the mind shutter, they're thrown out. So it's not about fighting those negative thoughts. It's about throwing them out, because now you're feeding your brain with new information. You see, negative and positive can't exist in the same place at the same time. So when you throw out the negative, when you bring in the positive information, the negative has to automatically leave by itself. You're not fighting it, you're not pushing it, you're not doing anything. It leaves by itself because you have chosen to bring in this new information into your mind. And that is how to stop the mind from negative thoughts. Don't listen to all the teachings out there, you know, do this exercise, do the blah, 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 blah. Really, if that worked, that would have worked 100 times by now. It doesn't work. And you know, I've tried all these personal development things and these self-help books and all these Buddhist peace teachings. I've tried that, and all these Hindu practices, I've tried that. But you know, when you get into all these peace teachings and all these practices, and these Buddhist teachers and these Hindu practices, guess what? You still can't stop the mind chatter. You still got bad habits. You still got, because that stuff just doesn't work. It's about not focusing on the problem and focusing on Jesus. And at the same time, focusing on the word of God. What is your problem? Finances. Find the verse that speaks about finances and focus on that. And you see how quickly that negative mind just goes and the new mind comes in. What is your problem? Marriage issues. Find the word of God that speaks about the marriage and then start focusing on that. And you see how quickly that negative mind goes and the new mind comes in. Because it's not just about focusing on how negative the marriage is. Then you're going to start to resent that person. Then you're going to start to hate that person. Then you're going to start to gossip about that person. And then as a man thinks in his mind and in his heart, so he is, says the Bible in Proverbs 23:7. As a man thinks in his heart, so he is. And so it's not just a problem. When you start dwelling in it, you're going to bring more and more and more problems into the equation. That's how everything grows, and it becomes like a snowball just out of control. So it's about focusing on Jesus. Stop focusing on the storm. Start focusing on the promises of God. So with that being said, let me know in the comments what you think. Give us a thumbs up. Because it does help the Facebook algorithm. When there's activity on the page, it helps Facebook get the channel out there, the video out there to more people. So if you haven't already subscribed, go ahead and do so. Click that notification button to get notified when I release a new video. And make sure to join our live prayer every Sunday, because we want to pray over you. Send us your prayer request. Information can be found in the description below. And until next time, God bless you.